Home Sweet Home. Eine müde, verkaterte Chloe um 7 Uhr. Ich könnte bei so einem Licht auch nicht schlafen. Ich muss echt sagen, bis jetzt macht Deck 9 einen richtig guten Job, die Atmosphäre des originalen Life is Strange einzufangen. Boah, da sieht Chloe gerade so jung aus. Wie alt ist sie hier eigentlich? Wir chillen mal noch eine Runde. Na gut.
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Wer das alte Life is Strange, mein Let's Play von dem ursprünglichen Life is Strange gesehen hat, der weiß, was jetzt kommt. Unweigerlich. Eine Leserunde. Also lehnt euch zurück, denn das könnte jetzt eine Weile dauern. Und wem das zu lange dauert, für den habe ich garantiert irgendeine Methode zu skippen. Dear Max, Dad got me the stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. And tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months, despite all my calls and texts and... Not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck! There's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe, the unfriended. Now this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Chloe, the Journal Boss. Ich liebe diese Tagebucheinträge. Ready? So Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. The wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David! Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then, or breathing. Hey, shit happens, as you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. She can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like I'm the asshole. Chloe, the asshole. So you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Pris just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. Think I just won her bangs. Chloe, the electric sheep. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Wanna know why? Because you weren't at Firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or, Mom, if you're reading this, he's my dealer and you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused this dump bouncer until he let me inside. Firewalk was the shit! Who knew ragers like that went down in little old Arcadia Bay? Fuck Seattle. Plus, I almost got my ass kicked. NBD. Ich weiß nicht, was NBD heißt. But there were these two asshole skeevy guys whose manhood I wrecked. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? Firewalk plus Chloe exceeds Max. That's the wrong term, but I don't care. So sieht's also in Chloes Kopf zurzeit aus. Kein Wunder, dass sie frustriert ist, dass Max weg ist und nicht antwortet. Ich frag mich auch immer noch echt, wieso Max nicht mehr geantwortet hat. Wer weiß, vielleicht wird das noch aufgeklärt. Charaktere. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me... Oh, okay. I am an inmate at Black Cell, wollte ich jetzt gerade sagen. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which, I get it. I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter, or student, or anything really. But who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection, and it sucks ass. Other things that suck: Mom's new drill sergeant, boyfriend David, how hard it is to buy weed around here, having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, Dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shitberg town. The pen I use to tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Frank. For a drug dealer, Frank Bowers is actually pretty chill. He likes to act like he's a tough guy, and I have no doubt that he's done a few messed up things over the years. But to me, he's like a scruffy dog. The tougher he tries to come off, the cuter he seems. I've been buying weed from Frank for close to a year. I almost never have enough money to pay him, and he always tells me, "It's the last fucking time, Chloe. I'm not your fucking friend." then he always gives it to me anyway. Like I said, guys, adorable. Of course, if I ever did anything to actually get on Frank's bad side, he might not seem so cuddly anymore. I hear Frank rolls with some dudes who are into way darker shit than keeping high schoolers medicated. It's hard to imagine Frank getting mixed up with anything really bad, but I guess you never know. For now, I'll just keep hoping that Frank is even worse at remembering who owes him money than he is at being intimidating. Despite Mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since Dad died. Money's tight, her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not at all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts like if I smoke pot or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be cool. But lately there's a hairy dick monster she let into the house that's fucking everything up. David Madsen, a jobless, brainless, dickless little shit with a hard-on for the military and a promise to whip me into shape. Asshole. I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that the David flu is the kind of disease that kills its host. Jetzt bin ich gespannt. Max Caulfield, missing in action ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy motherfucker loves photography more than life itself and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and saved people and shit. Ooh, foreshadowing. Then my dad died. And her dad got some job up north and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my texts so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore and that she probably has all new friends up in fucking Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, "Hey Chloe, wanna dress up like pirates and be stupid together?" I would take her back in a heartbeat. Lip dip. In a heartbeat. If I had a nickel back for every jerk off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple of years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again.
What's the matter? Don't you want to write your dear old Dad?
I guess they think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever. As if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. Semi-truck? And what the fuck am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad who was always fun to be around and never angry? That he treated me like an equal? That he was constantly working to make our lives better? That he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch, that he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy, and that its barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because... Oh, den haben wir sogar gesehen. Fällt mir gerade auf. Cool. Oder an sich nicht cool, aber nettes Detail. Wo waren wir? and that the barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mom and me to just pretend neither of us notices it. If that's coping, then coping can go fuck itself. But wait, there's more, is there? Oh, okay, diesmal sammeln wir Graffitis und nicht Fotos. Alles klar. Und das hier sind Orte und scheinbar können wir Notizen einsammeln. Interessant. So, aber irgendwo war doch noch... Stopp. Ah! Nee. Haben wir nicht irgendwo... Vielleicht auch nicht. Ich dachte, wir hätten irgendwo ein Handy vielleicht. Ich bin mir ziemlich sicher, dass es irgendwo eins gibt. Aber jetzt ist erstmal genug gelesen.
Hey Max. Hey Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Süßes Foto.
Rolling! Wakey wakey, eggy bakey. Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Wird's da etwa wieder Zeit, in die Schule zu gehen? Hey, Mr. Sharky. Moment. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. I've had a near-death experience eating there. Let us know. Keine Ahnung, worum's da ging.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Gut, dass dich das Kuscheltier daran erinnert.
Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows.
Aha.
Words of wisdom, don't fail me now.
Ist da im Original eins? Ich sag immer Original, auch wenn ich den Vorgänger meine oder das Sequel, was auch immer, ist es nicht wichtig. Ich weiß nicht, was das bedeutet. Wir werden sehen.
Everything's worth a shot.
Hm. Wahre Worte, I guess.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
Gut, dass man alle Gesichter so gut erkennen kann.
Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Totally not ready, oder was?
7.9 FM The Satyr is supported by listeners like you.
Dear Miss Arcadia, did you hear about Firewalk coming to town? Ah, so hat's es rausgefunden. I checked all the local venues, but nobody knows anything. Not all the local venues, apparently. Don't know, but I'm bumping the threat. Ich lese das jetzt nicht alles vor, könnt ihr selber machen.
What? Who? What photo?
Ich will auf den Link klicken. Hoffentlich kommt das gleich.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Debra. Mhm. Well then. Ein P ist E. Was willst du daran denn verbessern?
Better living through chemistry.
Oh boy. Nee, die Musik bleibt an.
Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast. I bet long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Da kennst du Max nicht.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Können wir das jetzt auswählen? Nee, geht nur der Raven. Passt aber nicht ganz irgendwie. Au, ich bin blöd. Okay, das nehmen wir nicht, weil, keine Ahnung, ist zwar cool zu haben, aber nachher sieht das irgendwer. Okay, jetzt denke ich wirklich weit. Bonus-Outfits? Das interessiert mich jetzt gerade mal. Ja, ich hab's am letzten Tag vorbestellt. Ist zwar theoretisch cool, aber passt irgendwie nicht rein. Anderes Bonus-Outfit? What the fuck? Nee, du, wir nehmen mal die eigentlich gewollten. Es war immer noch relativ brav, aber ich meine, es ist ein Prozess.
Can't leave without my vitamins. I really should get going.
Noch nicht.
Max gave me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Das ist der Soundtrack. Nice. Das wusste ich nicht, dass die CD sogar genauso aussieht.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
So, ich will aber immer noch das Kack-Handy finden. Es gibt es. Ich hab's doch beim letzten Mal gefunden. Wieso? Nee, definitiv nicht. Dann halt nicht.
Shit. Where's my phone?
Ah.
It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone. With moms. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Ach, es ist alles so bekannt. Schön.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia Bay.
Die gute Chloe ist echt noch ein ganz schöner Piratenfan.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Oder blau. Wie wär's damit?
Okay. Ins Schlafzimmer gehen wir dann wohl mal. Aber zuerst wird umgeschaut.
Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Tja, ja. Und was ist hier drin?
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
What do we have here?
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
Keine Ahnung, was das jetzt für eine Gameplay-Mechanik ist, weil da ja auch definitiv irgendwas aufgeploppt ist.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
What? Das macht man doch nicht.
I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old.
Beziehungsweise, wenn sie das macht, dann muss es...
I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
Wenn sie das macht, in Betracht zieht, dann... muss es der Familie Price echt nicht gut gehen.
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
Oder will sie nicht, dass David die ganzen Familienfotos sieht? Oder will sie nicht? Tut's vielleicht einfach zu sehr weh? Aber es gehört nach draußen.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
Wahrscheinlich ist das Illuminati-Symbol der neue Schmetterling oder so.
Mom's finally making her bed again. I guess that's a good sign.
Gut, angerufen.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Was ein Bilderrahmen. Gut, es ist im Haus. Das ist doch schon mal ein Vorteil.
It sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
Im Klo. Da!
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Auf in die zweite Runde. Ganz nach oben. So. Will you be joining us for supper? No, thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Das wird ein super Gespräch unten gleich. Freue ich mich schon drauf. Wer ist Elliot? Ach du Scheiße. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Oh, lo siento. Ich weiß nicht, was das heißt. Ich kann kein Spanisch. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What are you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Oh, okay. What the fuck? Moment. You finished the chew? Chem? Homework. Okay. Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. Your shit's here.
Hell yeah!
But you tapped out, sorry. Your loss. Hey, can you... Hey, you can hold it for me a day. Was? Hey, you can hold it for me a day. Can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? You still owe. Gonna have me whacked? Yes, please. Joke about that over text. I'm your deal drugs on this phone. Anyway, come. Und jetzt 420. Ich habe mich gerade dazu entschieden, dass ich nicht alles an SMS vorlese, weil das irgendwie nicht so cool kommt. Das lese ich noch vor. Das ist mir wichtig.
So sorry. I've been bad about emailing. Texting is better for me anyway.
Yo, it's Max. How's it going? You there?
Ah, sorry again. I've been really busy.
Gute Entschuldigung.
You'd love Seattle. More in a bit.
So, das war am 13.11.2009. Cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future? Hey, Hippie. Das war... Moment, ich kann mir nichts merken. 13.11. 28.11. Ist lang her, aber geht noch.
I'm so sorry. Maybe we should set up a time to call.
No worries. I'll check my dance card. 7 p.m. in Arcadia Bay. What is it? 2019 in Seattle?
I know, right? Maybe this weekend.
Sure, anytime. Let me know. Yo, Queen of the Crickets. What's the latest? Max. Das ist echt kacke von Max. Zumal sie ja echt keinen richtigen Grund gehabt zu haben scheint.
Naja.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Yes, you did. Right here.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.